Hey guys, when it comes to Ryzen CPUs, we are all aware that memory plays a crucial role. Unlike with Intel CPUs, higher frequency isn't always better in this case. For the Ryzen 7000 and 9000 series, the sweet spot for DDR5 is 6000 MHz in order to maintain 1-to-1 ratio with the memory controller. So UCLK should be equal to MIM clock, since memory manufacturers are well aware of this. Instead of pushing higher frequency, they've started focusing on tighter timings for Ryzen optimized X4 memory kits. So I went ahead and grabbed Gscale latest DDR5 6000 CL26 memory kit, specifically the Trident Z5 Royal Neo, and it's their latest memory kit for Ryzen with the lowest timings they've ever offered and largely marketed for DDR5. But that's not all. I also picked up another kit from Lixar, Ares Gen 2, which also features CL26. So you see, both kits share the same main cache latency, but as we'll see later on, there are some notable differences in sub-timing ones. So if you are looking for the best performance with the lowest memory timings, in this video I'll be comparing both kits in various scenarios and benchmarks in order to see which one truly earns the performance crown. Here I am in the BIOS to show you. First up is the Gscale Trident Z5 Royal Neo. I've enabled the expo profile it ships with, and here we can see the standard timings and the sub ones it has. And you can see that I've installed actually 4 sticks. Each one has 16 GB, for a total of 64 GB running at expo. And they have been fully stable on my PC without any kind of modifications I've done. Next we have here the Lixar Ares Gen 2. I also enabled here expo and confirmed the profile correctly applied. And here are the timings they have. It's the same capacity setup, 4 16 GB sticks totaling 64 GB. Now placing the two side by side, we can start to spot some difference. While both models use SK Hynix memory chips, sometimes they vary slightly. The Gscale Trident Z5 Royal Neo runs at 26, 36, 36, 96, where the Lixar Ares Gen 2 has 26, 36, 36, 68. So you can see that Lixar offers a lower thrust in its primary timing. But that's not all. Also, bank cycle time, TRC, is also different. 132 clocks for Gscale versus 104 for Lixar, along with a slightly lower TRD/RDDD by 1. But still, for me personally, the lower thrust on the Lixar really caught up my attention, and that's why it actually made me decide to compare them and ultimately make this video. However, on the bright side, Z5 Royal Neo operates at a slightly lower voltage, at 1.4, so it might allow you to tweak it further to match or even surpass Lixar timings. For this video though, I'm testing both kits as they come out of the box using the expo profile for 100% stability. So during benchmarks, the CPU I'll be using is the Beast Ryzen 9950X3D with fully tuned PBO and curve shaper. And here are my current curve values and are very stable. You can check out this suggested video here to learn more about my PBO tuning for it. As for the motherboard I'll be using, it's Aorus flagship AMD board, the X870E Extreme AI Top. I gotta say, this board is amazing in my opinion. Rock solid stability, excellent VRM, a massive heatsink for drives, and all you need for fans or ARGB headers. And most importantly, given its lower price than competition like ASUS Extreme or MSI Godlike, I would say it's a decent choice. Now, in order to avoid any GPU bottlenecking for gaming benchmarks we'll see later on, I'm pairing the setup with the RTX 5090 Aorus Master. It's also a fantastic GPU. I've done multiple videos on it, covering overclocking, coil wind, and testing out the force fan it comes with for extra cooling. So by using it, I'm quite confident it's the perfect fit for this kind of memory testing. Now, before getting started with any benchmark and all, testing RAM stability is crucial, even when we are using an expo profile. So I always recommend to test it out on your system, like make sure to do some stress test for RAM, etc. Whether by using this RAM test software or by using IDA64 system stability, which is trial free. Anyway, I made sure both kits were fully stable by running RAM stress test for about an hour on each. with 4 sticks, both came back with 0 errors. Now is the time for benchmark, starting with IDA64 memory benchmark for read, write, copy, and latency. Now you can see here are the results we got. For read speed, G-Scale Triton Z5 Royal Neo scored 81,467 MB, while Lexar Ares Gen 2 82,170 MB. For write speed, both scored similarly, slightly above 86,000 MB. As for copy speed, again very close, with Lexar being ahead by about 200 MB, but that could also fall within margin of error. Finally, latency is identical on both at 68 nanoseconds. So, as far as in this synthetic test, both kits perform nearly the same. Now for fun, I wanted to try on Cinebench 2024. Even if it doesn't really benefit for lower memory timings, it's more of a CPU benchmark, but I tested it anyway. On multi-core, the Lexar Ares Gen 2 scored just 7 points higher, which is within the margin of error, so again, performance here is essentially the same. But now, here where things get interesting. As soon as we switch to gaming tests, we'll start to notice some difference. So I tested 10 different games at 1080p on low settings to remove any kind of GPU bottlenecking, and to better highlight CPU and memory behavior. So in Cyberpunk 2077, Ares Gen 2 came out ahead by 6 FPS on average, and 4 better in low FPS. But next in Black Myth Wukong, G-Scale actually performed better by around 3 FPS on average, with exact same low FPS. So I don't know which one will be better in this case. I will say that they're about the same. Like, given that we have the same low FPS, maybe it could be around the same. Third game we have is Counter-Strike 2. Here Ares Gen 2 led by about 4 FPS on average, with exact same low FPS. So it could be around the same on G-Scale. Our next game is Horizon Zero Dawn. Here we got Royal Neo at 380 FPS on average, while Ares Gen 2 at 384 with higher low FPS, so it overall gave a slight edge to Ares Gen 2. While in Borderlands 3, no average FPS difference, but Ares Gen 2 had better 0.1% loss. As you can see, there is like less FPS drop. In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, Ares Gen 2 claimed 3 more FPS on average and noticeably better low FPS by around 8. Now, in this one, Dirt 5 Ares Gen 2 showed a jump of 6 FPS higher on average, with low also improved by 6 as well. So you can see in some titles we get higher gains with lower memory timings, even if they are different in 2 or 3 types, so not necessarily all of them. Next we have is Age of Mythology Retold. While both scored exactly the same, 1831.88 in the game benchmark, but our average FPS is actually higher on Ares Gen 2 by 3 FPS. Now let's head into a title with game engines that tends to benefit from higher cache and better memory timing, such as Assassin's Creed Shadows. Here Ares Gen 2 had a big lead, 192 versus 180 FPS average. So we got 12 higher averages with much, much better loss. I got to say it's truly significant on this one. Now finally in Rainbow Six Siege, no advantage for Ares Gen 2 because Royal Neo scored somehow better. One thing that made me confused though, in this kit, Lexar claims latency as low as 55 nanoseconds in their marketing. But in IDA64, as you saw when we tested it, got actually 68 nanoseconds. So what's the deal? Well, it turns out that kind of latency they market is often measured under ideal lab conditions, not in a real-world Windows environment, or perhaps with 2 sticks rather than 4. So don't expect that 55 nanosecond number to show up in your system. It's more of a theoretical spec for marketing. Anyway, that wraps it up for this video. We saw that Lexar Ares Gen 2 did offer some improvement in some gaming titles, given its lower class, TRC, and TRD, RDDD, but nothing massively game-changing. Both kits are incredibly fast and feature ultra-tight timings. I believe you could still tweak the G-Scale kit to reach lower latencies, but I kept everything stock for this test. So after seeing this, if you had to pick, Which one will you go for? Also, let me know in the comments which RAM kit you are currently using for your Ryzen or even if it's Intel. There is no preference, I like both equally. And I really hope that this video has helped you understand the subtle difference when considering low latency memory kits for your Ryzen build. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and check out my other tuning and optimization guides. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.